Hi everyone, this is Nick, and I posted a video a couple days ago on how to morph different charts that started out as live charts in PowerPoint from one to another. So you could morph a pie chart into a bar chart, into a column chart, into a donut chart, things like that. And that was a pretty long video, and one of the cool techniques in there was this sort of choose your own adventure style presentation, and I wanted to just do a really condensed video on that specific technique. So in this technique, you can actually put your slide, your PowerPoint slides in slideshow mode, and then you can use your mouse to go ahead and click on a different button somewhere where you put a hyperlink in the presentation, and that will take you to a specific slide in your presentation. And I'm gonna do it really easily right here with just two slides, but you can take this technique on your own and do it to as many different slides as you want to. And it doesn't just have to be showing charts, it could be any type of sort of choose your own adventure path that you wanna do. So right here, I have two slides. This is my pie chart slide. These are my two buttons right here. They're just shapes that I put in. They're rectangles with rounded corners. I want the pie chart to be darker on this because when we're on the pie chart slide, I want it to show the pie. And then on my second slide here, I swapped the colors there so that the pie chart is this light gray and the bar chart is this dark. So that will indicate once we're putting this in slideshow mode that we're on the bar chart way. So all we have to do here is we have to right click. You can ascribe any sort of hyperlink to any object or text box in PowerPoint by right-clicking, click on link right here, and then the menu pops up right here, the insert hyperlink menu pops up. You can put in an address to a URL, it could go to a website, or you can click on this that says place in document, and then it shows all of your different slides. Now I'm gonna say slide title, slide one, and slide two. We only have two slides right here. And so I'm gonna go ahead and click on this because I want, when the pie chart is selected, when that button is selected, I want it always to go to slide number one. Okay, so we're gonna push okay. I'm gonna do the same thing with the bar, right click, hyperlink, place in document, and now I want that one to go to slide number two. And now we have to apply the same hyperlinks to these buttons. Now if I wanted to, I could actually just go ahead and delete these. And since these already have those links ascribed to it, I'm just gonna highlight both of them, Control C to copy, and Control V, they'll paste in the exact same positions. And now let's go ahead and put this in slideshow mode and see if it works. Slideshow mode there. All right, we're clicking on the pie. Nothing should happen because it should stay on this slide. Click on the bar, and it goes to the bar. Ah, but as you see, I forgot to update those colors. So that's kind of another user interface thing that we want to create. So I'm going to escape out of this. And then what I'm going to do here is I am going to push Control Shift C. That that copies the formatting. I'm going to go over here and say Control Shift V. That pastes the formatting. And I'm going to do that one more time with the bar. Control Shift C there because I want the pie to be grayed out. Now let's put this in slideshow mode and see what happens. Bar chart there, pie chart, bar chart, pie chart, pie chart, bar chart, pie chart, bar chart, pie chart. Pretty cool. A pretty fun technique that you can use in your next PowerPoint presentation. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up. Make sure to click the bell next to it after you subscribe so that you can get notified every time I post a new updated tutorial in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. We love PowerPoint. Remember, you don't have to be a professional designer to look like one using the software that you have access to and use every single day. I had a great time making this video for you, and I will see you all next time.